गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 9। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस द पोयम रेन ऑन द रूफ। द पोएट ऑफ दिस पोयम इज स्कॉट स्किनले। इन दिस पोयम द पोएट हैज गिवन ए वेरी फाइन इमेजिनेशन व्हाइल ही लिसन टू द पैटर ऑफ द रेन ऑन द रूफ। ही इज लॉस्ट इन वेरीड आइडियाज एंड फील्स द प्रेजेंस ऑफ हिज मदर। द क्लाउड्स क्रिएट डार्कनेस for the starry sky and in turn it shows its unhappiness through tears of rain. On one side there is happiness while on the other there is unhappiness. Now see stanza 1. When the humid shadows hover over all the starry spheres and the melancholy darkness gently weeps in rainy tears, what a bliss to press the pillow of a cottage chamber bed and lie listening to the patter of the soft rain overhead. Yes, in this some difficult words are used. Humid, something which is full of moisture. Shadows refers to the moisture. Leaden clouds which cast a shadow on the earth, hover, move around something, melancholy, sad, bliss, happiness, patter, the sound of raindrops falling on the roof, cottage chamber means the bedroom. In this stanza, the poet is saying that when the humid shadows hover, here humid shadow refers to dark clouds which are full of water. The poet is saying that when the sky is full of these clouds which are moisture laden, are full of water and are about to bring rain, when such clouds hover around in the sky, overall the starry spheres at that time whose clouds which are full of moisture move around in the sky and the sad darkness of the night is wiped off by the raindrops which seem like tears falling from the sky. The poet is comparing raindrops to tears and he says that the dark sky which seems to be very sad, it appears as if it is crying and the raindrops are the tears shed by it. He adds that it is like a blessing to lie on the bed in his. Now see stanza 2. Every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart and a thousand dreamy fancies into bushy being star and a thousand recollections weave their hair threads into boom as I listen to the patter of the rain upon the roof. Tinkle means short light ringing sound, shingles rectangular wooden tiles used on the roofs, echo repeated sound, woof the thread woven across the loom, patter the sound of raindrops on the roof. Busy being refers to human beings and here the poet is referring to himself. The poet is expressing his feelings when he hears the raindrop falling on the rooftop of his house. He says that every tinkle on the shingles has an echo in the heart. Whenever he hears rain falling on the rooftop, the sound repeats in his heart and in his dreams. He has many different fanciful imagination. He adds that this sound of the rain falling on the rooftop creates many new different dreams in his mind. He recollects many memories of the past which come back into his mind as if it is like dream. So he says that as he listened to the patter of the rain upon the roof, he has many new dreams in his mind and the memories of the past come back in the form of dreams. Now in memory, now in memory comes my mother as she used in years ago to regard the darling dreamers or she left them till the dawn. Oh, feel her fond look on me as I listen to this refrain which is played upon the shingles by the patter of the rain. Yes, students. Here, ar means old poetic word before, dawn, daybreak, list, old poetic word for listen, refrain, a repeated part of a song or a poem. Here, the poet introduces his mother. He says that he is dreaming of his mother, as he had told in the previous stanza that rain brings memories of the past. It is the memory of his mother who is no longer alive. In the past, she used to love him a lot. She used to consider him a darling, and she would let him sleep till daybreak and have sweet dreams. The poet can still feel that his mother is looking at him as he listens to the song made by the raindrops falling on the rooftop of his room. The sound of the rain makes him correlate his past with his present. That is why the poet is moved by the sound of the raindrops on the shingles of his room whenever he hears this sound. It brings back memories of the past and he is reminded of his mother. Now see, so many literary devices are used in this poem. Rhyme scheme of the poem is A, B, C, D, D, E, F, alliteration. If consonant sound in two or more consecutive words, as for example, humid, humid hover, H sound, starry spheres, S is repeated, press pillow, P is repeated, lie listening, L sound is repeated. Onomatopoeia, the use of sound words to create a dramatic effect and auditory imagery. And patter is the use of the sound of words. So here is onomatopoeia. Personification, treating a non-living thing as living being, as rain. Darkness has been personified when he says that he is sad. So, students, literary devices are used here, and you can find some others. Thank you.